Thank you very much, Heather, for that kind introduction. And so pleased to see colleagues scattered in towns and cities across the United States. So great to see diplomacy in action here. It's really a great honor for me to be here to open the first Diplomacy Begins Here Summit of 2018. I can't think of a better place to highlight how women rock the world than right here in Cleveland. I'd like to begin by thanking Maura O'Donnell McCarthy, CEO of the Cleveland Council on World Affairs. Maura, I met you in about a split second coming in the door there. I'd like to echo Heather's thanks to you and your team for putting together this summit. I'd also like to thank Catherine Brown and her team at Global Ties US, who continue to be key partners for the State Department in administering exchanges across the country. I have the great pleasure of working with motivated citizen diplomats throughout the country to implement exchange programs. As Heather said, the State Department's Bureau of Educational and Cultural Affairs, ECA, seeks to advance U.S. foreign policy around the world through academic, professional youth, cultural, and sports exchange programs. We bring thousands of students, teachers, government officials, business executives, and civil society leaders to the United States each year, and we send hundreds of Americans overseas as well. ECA supports the growth and development of women and girls through exchanges, which foster leadership, communication, and decision-making skills. Women's empowerment is a top priority for our Bureau and indeed for the administration. Our exchange program participants receive mentoring, language and technical skills training, as well as resources to sustain and build on their exchange program experiences. Our participants are current and future leaders from various backgrounds. They are entrepreneurs, scientists, teachers, students, scholars, government and political leaders, journalists, athletes, artists, and civil society activists. I probably don't have to tell you all of this, since you are the ones who host these amazing people around the country. In the last year, we committed over $25 million in exchange programs specifically designed to empower women and girls, and reached over 150,000 women and girls around the world. But we can always use more help and more partners. That's one reason why we're here today. One of ECA's flagship programs that you all are intimately familiar with is the International Visitor Leadership Program, or the IVLP. We in government can't get even through one sentence without an acronym, so forgive me. In all, approximately 5,000 current and emerging international leaders come to the United States on the program each year. The Cleveland Council on World Affairs plays an integral role in hosting many of our IVLP participants right here in your community. Almost half of our IVLP participants every year are women, and last year, ECA implemented 43 IVLP projects specifically focused on women's empowerment for more than 500 participants from around the world. One very special IVLP project on women's empowerment took place last October, and it fits in nicely with the theme of this year's summit. Following U.S. Embassy and Consulate screenings of the film Hidden Figures in more than 100 countries throughout 2017, ECA launched an IVLP project called #HiddenNoMore, Empowering Women Leaders in STEM. During the three-week project, 48 women scientists and engineers from 48 countries explored ways to increase the participation of women and girls in STEM fields by collaborating with scientists and engineers across the United States. I'm happy to announce that we are launching Hidden No More Part 2 with a special sequel IVLP project opening this October. I'm so pleased to see the lineup of speakers that Heather announced this morning, who will be discussing their work in this field that we at the State Department view as a key foreign policy priority. A bit later this morning, you will also hear from one of our IVLP alumni who is using her exchange experience to make a strong impact in her home country of Liberia. I had the pleasure of meeting her earlier this week, and I think you will be as impressed as I was with her accomplishments, so that we've invited her on a second IVLP project as one of our distinguished Gold Star alumni. I mentioned the need for strong partnerships earlier, and I'm proud to say that you, the nonprofit organizations, businesses, community members, and citizen diplomats of Cleveland and beyond are ECA's essential partners. You help us make the local connections that make people-to-people diplomacy effective. You are that essential last 3 feet of diplomacy, to use a phrase that Edward R. Murrow made famous. We simply could not have the same policy impact without you. You already know that effective engagement isn't limited to government diplomats, but that it takes place when ordinary people from different cultures realize that they share similar challenges, desires, and concerns. Diplomacy isn't limited to officials at the negotiating table. It occurs when citizen diplomats take visitors to the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame or on a cruise along the bank of Lake Erie. I understand there was a trial run last night. Or shopping at West Side Market. Diplomacy is when our participants visit your homes for dinner or meet with local organizations to discuss shared challenges and successes. The impact of what you do each day right here in Cleveland has ripple effects around the world. As they ascend the career ladders and their chosen specialties, our alumni overseas become some of our embassy's strongest partners. Currently, one-third of all world leaders are alumni of U.S. government exchange programs. More than 500 current and former heads of state have participated in the International Visitor Leadership Program. Their nuanced understanding of American culture and society makes them current and potential partners for the United States in creating a more peaceful, secure, and prosperous world. This door-to-door diplomacy could not happen without our community-based partners, members, and most importantly, volunteers. I'd like to give a particular shout out to volunteers. You are the lifeblood of the Cleveland Council on World Affairs, of Global Ties, and indeed of American society. Every international visitor returns home with an understanding of the essential role volunteers play in American society. And in many cases, visitors take the spirit of volunteerism home with them. I have never heard an international visitor return without expressing surprise, pleasure, and excitement at the volunteers they met across the United States. In Mongolia, members of our alumni association now volunteer to teach English, to engage people with disabilities, and to clean up trash to preserve Mongolia's pristine steppe, all skills they learned in the United States. Cleveland is consistently a highlight of visitors' trips to the United States, and past anecdotes demonstrate that participants develop a strong connection with the people they meet here. Last year alone, Cleveland hosted more than 300 international visitors on nearly 50 different projects. The diversity of projects you host is a testament to the strength of the resources Cleveland offers. In the last year, projects have focused on topics as diverse as cybersecurity, government accountability, youth leadership, small business development, and public health. In preparation for this trip, I tried to find the one thing that Cleveland does well, only to discover you offer a wide range of valuable opportunities for all of our participants, and alumni can attest that apparently you do all of these things well. Sifting through many stories, I've selected two recent anecdotes to give you a glimpse into the ripple effect I mentioned a moment ago. In October of last year, 7 visitors from Cambodia visited the Innovation Fund of Lorain County Community College and the Think Box of Case Western Reserve University. Both are sites committed to the innovation, research, and funding that make startups possible. The visitors participated in Startup Weekend Cleveland to share their expertise with local entrepreneurs. We have since heard from our embassy in Cambodia that, quote, "This IVLP project has sparked new levels of public-private tech cooperation, increased investor interest in alumni's tech companies, generated positive press coverage about the potential of Cambodia's tech sector, and brought new prominence for the 7 Cambodian participants." Just as importantly, it has presented an opportunity to position the United States and American companies to play a critical role at the inception of a new industry and forge mutually beneficial connections at the earliest stage. A ripple indeed. A second example is 12 visitors from North Africa and the Middle East who visited Cleveland last December as part of a project highlighting the U.S. commitment to the free exchange of ideas. Participants were inspired by their visits to the Cleveland Plain Dealer and the Cleveland City Club, noting these organizations were a good model of democracy at work. So, colleagues, this is why citizen diplomacy matters. And this is why I thank all of you for being here today. Diplomacy really does begin here. It begins with global citizens who want to share their stories. It begins with dedicated volunteers who believe that trying to understand one another makes the first step toward a more peaceful world. It begins when exchange programs like the IVLP inspire people to come together, create life-changing experiences that make us all want to commit to make the world a better place, one visitor at a time. Thank you for taking time out of your busy schedules to welcome our participants into your homes and your businesses, for sharing your stories with emerging leaders from around the world, and for continuing to be such good partners with the Department of State. Thank you very much.